Kingswood.
It's not a Hummer.
This is not a Kingswood. This is a Hummer.
And you're watching Hummer TV with Kingswood.
Hey guys, Dando here for Hummer TV now. I'm joined by two members of the band who are responsible for the epic blockbuster that is Some Motherfuckers Gotta Pay. They are Kingswood. How are we doing, my good friends?
Excellent.
Now, Alex, are you comfortable down there? I believe that means A-OK. Is that A-OK or...? Yes, it's double A. Double thumbs up. So you guys are flying to Tassie tonight.
We're flying out to Tassie today.
Today? What time?
At 1:30.
can you put this up?
And then... we're going to play Launceston.
Yeah.
And then we're playing Hobart. And then we're going to go to Mona. And it's going to be really wonderful.
Are you guys good flyers?
Funny you should mention that. Flying is one of our major...
activities?
Mm. But not in aeroplanes.
I don't have a minty yeah. We're doing an interview.
In which sense?
You gave me one.
Yeah, but now you're like, well, flying is really wonderful.
Am I? Maybe I'll just tuck it neatly in the side of my cheek, like you did in our video clip.
Blink, I guess.
Yep.
Put that back, and I'll never.
So getting so with flying, what? How is it? One of the good things that you do? You said not in aeroplanes. In what sense did you mean?
In the same way that Man of Steel uses.
Oh, flight. Really? Are you a fan of Superman?
I saw that movie.
Did you like it? I've watched an illegal copy of it, so that maybe that brought the quality of the film down.
Is that like when they leaked, what was that other movie, and all the effects were like half done?
Oh, that was the Hugh Jackman one.
That's right. Yeah. And it was like, it all of a sudden just go to like a really bad CGI, but not layered.
No, I realised, yeah. What would be the worst film you've seen this year?
What's the worst film? The worst film I've seen in a couple of years, which is just so wonderfully shit, is The Lucky One with Zac Efron.
I haven't seen that.
Don't.
Worst movie of all time.
Right?
Should I see it for that reason?
And the reason we went and saw it, Alex, is because...
I was forced to go to see it.
You were forced to go on a date because you were being a really nice guy.
I was being such a nice
guy. And we went and sat behind you and threw popcorn at you and had to go through that movie.
That was more entertaining than the movie itself.
More entertaining than what you're doing right now.
This Hummer is ridiculous. There is so much space, I can do
flips. Do a somersault down there. Can you pull this off? Here we go.
Like down the thing?
Do it coming
back
up.
If shit goes down...
I'll definitely be able to do it. Ready, check this out.
Here we go.
Go.
It's happening. Oh, there we go.
How was that fall?
What would you give it out of 10?
Well, 10 for effort. I've never seen anyone do a voluntary... somersault in a Hummer.
So much room! I go down here.
You can't be doing that.
Be like, hey, what's up?
No, you can't.
Be like, hey, wow, you're so far away.
Can you edit what comes up on the little prompter thing?
I can't, but it's cheek hand in there. Well, what would you want it to say?
I don't know, just hello. Just be nice. Say, how are you? Anyway.
So let's talk about Some Motherfuckers Gotta Pay.
The best movie you've seen this year.
It is the best movie I've seen this year. What was the idea was it to have the subtitles at the start? Is that an actual language you're speaking?
It's overdubbed, so it's not us.
Oh, it's not you speaking?
Well, Alex does the overdubs for everyone. He's fluent in Japanese.
Really? He's young.
You're
really bad, like...
For talking?
Mm. But it's good for his breath. Mm. It smells good.
Does my breath smell bad?
Oh, really? No, he sort of overrides
it. You're a coffee man.
I've got like a coffee breath thing going
and
on.
And I hate coffee, so it's not a good thing, but he's overriding it.
Bullshit.
Get him mini sauce.
Hummer sucks.
It's very Tarantino-esque. Do you reckon he's watched it, the video?
No, I don't know. Hopefully it gets to him somehow. That'd be nice. He'd probably hate it, though.
Why would he hate it?
Maybe he'd be like, you little freaks.
Maybe he's flattered by the idea that we would pay homage.
Yeah. Well, he pays homage.
He does. It's the same concept.
Maybe when you go to...
A lot of his movies, particularly Kill Bill and Death Proof and stuff like that, he's like, it's a tribute. Well, it is to a certain
Are you fans style. Of his, like Pulp Fiction and shit like that?
When we came up with the whole idea, we were watching... he actually had the box set of all the Tarantino's work. On tour.
Blu-ray or DVD?
DVD.
Oh, so good.
And we were watching that the whole time, and that's when we were driving going, let's make that movie.
Let's make a Tarantino tribute movie.
Paid off well.
Thank you very much.
Do you think like Seth Centurion should make like a prequel or a sequel for their next film clip to that film and keep the thing going?
Funny you mention this. We've already got calls from friends of ours in other bands that weren't in the movie that want to do this, either do the sequel or prequel.
With a whole new group of bands. Mm. And like ask permission if they could like carry it on.
Because we're now the godfathers of this of this concept. Yeah. And he's like, you know, and then at the end you guys could like, you know, like it could pan to like a hospital bed and one of you is like and your eyes and you're not dead. Yes. You know?
And we'll return in the
Yeah. Like it's all
who
like,
are these bands that have contacted you?
Ah, that's top secret information.
Oh, come on.
Can't tell you stuff like that. Come on, man. It's more exciting. Mystery. Which one of these? What is it?
Are you gonna
ring or something?
Yeah, here.
I've got a wedding ring.
Hang on.
But I'll take that off, because she's filming.
Okay.
Which one do you want?
No.
What?
You just failed the test big time.
What?
You want that one because you're the mystery. You don't know what
you don't know what's in this hand. You already know you got a ring.
Which hand?
If you had to choose, what would you choose?
I'm not making the sequel to this one, am I?
No, because you just went out blatantly for the ring.
Now you got a ring.
Have the ring, man.
Can I keep this ring? You can keep my wedding ring.
Yeah, cool.
Even though my wife's filming this interview.
No, that's great.
Minty alert.
That's
so you're cool.
Can we just stop at a pawn shop, please?
So now, Nicola, the camera girl, you're now married to Ferg. How do you feel about this? How do you feel about being married to my wife?
Hey, this is
how do I feel
so
about
weird.
No inscription on
Luckily,
the wedding ring.
These neon lights are here because it kind of fits. So now there's a three-way thing going on.
So the,
I'm just gonna go up here again.
The gig at Corner, the second one sold out. The first one hasn't. Isn't it kind of weird for the first one to not be sold out, but the second one?
No, because the first one was the only one.
Okay.
And it sold out, and then we announced the second one, which happens to be
beforehand.
Yeah, it's like a prequel.
Do you feel like God's eating to sell out gigs in Melbourne?
It felt great to start a Corner, and it looks like the second one is going to sell out as well.
Oh no.
Clean the windows.
Here we go. Who I don't need to do this anymore. I don't know whether he's doing a very good job of cleaning the windows.
Oh, man. I cleaned the Mustang in the movie.
Oh,
how good does the Mustang look in that movie? I'm an expert. This chamois isn't up to standard.
No, you had like a special suitcase flown in from Japan.
That's it.
Right?
Off eBay.
With all these, I don't know, he's got all these different like cloths and he spends most of the time filming polishing his car. It's his car, the Mustang.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm going to do
it. Do like
a... Oh, here we go. The other way, everyone.
Don't die, we've got to... Sorry.
That was kind of anticlimactic.
Hey man, I'd like to see you do a dive in a
hummer. Oh, it wouldn't be that good.
Yeah.
Well, let's talk about the album.
Yes.
Yes, it's all set in stone. Or are you guys going to be winging it in the studio as well?
Do you mean songs-wise?
Yeah,
like
songs-wise,
what's happening?
Yeah.
Half and half.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't know. There's lots of songs done, but there's some that aren't done yet. And we don't know if there'll be grand pianos or violins or bazookas on the album.
Can they please do that?
The concept...
We've actually recorded with bazooka before.
Bazooka?
He means bazooki.
Yeah.
Bazooki.
But, the idea...
What's a bazooka?
It's a big gun.
Oh, here we go. No, it's not. It's a poorly pronounced big gun.
Yeah.
Bazooka.
We're
it's like a Japanese
bazooka.
Guy. That's the third Japanese reference in the whole time. Let's shoot a bazooka.
Bazooka.
It's not racist, is it?
Give me the
bazooka. No.
The concept of recording with someone like Vance Powell means he has a particular expertise and knowledge and experience in the art of recording albums and is very, very, very good at it. So we kind of want to utilize someone like that in the studio rather than going, hey, these are the songs, this is exactly how they're going to be, blah, blah, blah. It's all ready to go. We kind of want it to be a creative process.
And see what his input is.
Well, totally, yeah. Otherwise, if... What's the point? It's just someone who's really good at recording the sound otherwise, you know what I mean?
Because he's those people.
Yeah.
Do you feel like you have to be on your best behaviour over there?
I think
no
he's
going to... assaults and whatnot?
I don't think so.
Like, yeah, we've been like Skyping and from the sounds of things, he's going to be less productive than where you think.
He's very, very funny.
He's like, we'll sit up, we'll drink whiskey.
I just bought like...
You've got so many whiskeys.
Bought like 100 gallons of whiskey.
Yeah.
He's like part of this whiskey club.
It's been the first 4 days just drinking and talking.
He's like a biker wizard. He's got like a huge beard, but he's bald and like he's kind of like tough. But he's like this magician of sound, you know.
Do you like whiskey though?
Yes.
We love it.
Oh, it works out well. Though.
Yeah.
But we love Scotch whiskey. He's a big bourbon whiskey man.
Mm.
He's part of a bourbon club. See, we know all this because he's told us in great detail.
Over Skype.
Over Skype.
What's the creepiest thing he said to you over Skype?
You've had a couple of one-on-ones with him.
Yeah, but he doesn't say creepy things in that one. He tells us a lot of stories about Jack White.
Yeah, such as?
Such as Jack recently bought a Tesla sports car. Like Nikola Tesla invented all these, like the coils. All this, like, electricity-based power. Supposedly,
he's a man.
Supposedly that the corporation has been developing and all behind the scenes. I'm pretty sure he's been dead.
Yeah, like
very, in the 18 something. Yeah. maybe not. Maybe he's alive, being generated by electricity.
Yeah. Did he bought that Einstein guitar? He just bought it out last week. It's sick.
Well, actually, Einstein probably lived longer than Nikola Tesla, probably.
Because Tesla electrocuted himself in the end, didn't he?
So he's like, what's dead. That
what's
big
the story? What's the tech?
I don't know. So he bought the Tesla, the prototype sports car and whatever, and it goes to like 103 seconds, but it's completely silent.
What?
Because it's electrically powered. It's not like it doesn't have a combustion engine.
You should get Jack White to tag you in a ride.
Well, we plan to if it's a possibility. But yeah, he'll say stuff. He'll go, yeah, Jack took me out in this car, and it was like, boom! Hey, fuckers! Like, it's really wild guy. Awesome. It's really cool.
Are you still making him use corny pickup lines?
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah, those two girls in.
Hey, you. Do you want to see, or have you ever had a ride to Kingswood or something?
What? Or, that's never happened.
Or do you want to meet the drummer of Kingswood?
Yeah, I said that to a girl once. And then was...
And then took, yeah, it was Justin, that wasn't me. No, I'm perfectly capable.
I thought you were saying you're talking about when I said that thing, she had a name on her necklace, and then it went south.
No, there was one time when you gave me all this confidence and advice, and you were like, just go up to her and invite her to a gig or something like that, and it went terribly bad, and she was like...
That was the one in the... Yeah, in the real, like, no.
Yeah.
Oh, I think that's a different story.
Violet for real, if you're watching.
So you've offended a lot of women.
No, why are we offending women now?
We don't offend anyone.
it's a compliment to try and pick up a girl with a cheese.
You seem like a gentleman, I'll give you that.
Thank you.
You seem like a fun person.
That's it. That's the opposite of a gentleman. You seem like a gentleman, and you seem like a fun person. Fuckhead.
You seem like the kind of guy I want to hang out with when I'm having fun. That's basically what you just said.
Pretty much.
So you go and have dinner with me, and then you go out clubbing with Alex.
Yeah, baby.
If I went out clubbing, do you guys go out clubbing?
Oh yeah, every weekend. That's what we're about.
Alex jumped off this is a stage, like a dancing stage, like a platform.
But it wasn't
like
a nightclub.
Pontoon.
It wasn't a nightclub.
No, it was like a soul club.
Oh, yeah.
And decided to do a forward flip, much like he just did in this Hummer.
I've got a thing with perpetual
and
motion.
And just smacked this guy in the back of the head with his boot.
Yeah, I kicked a guy. Did it one.
And the security guards will come over and he's like, I understand, I'm leaving, I've done a stupid thing.
Yeah. You don't have to escort me out.
Yeah. Yeah. I went to Grammy and I said, listen, I know I've done something very dumb. I'm
going to bleeding on the ground over there.
And then I told the security guy on the outside, and he thought it was hilarious and let me back in.
Oh, really?
It's a very true story.
Right, well, we've come to a halt, so I feel like leave.
I feel like I can feel the rumble of the Hummer.
It's like, get out.
Yeah. Look, we're outside the Bohemia Cabaret Club.
Here in South Melbourne.
Here in sunny South Melbourne.
Cool. All right, well, thanks for that time, guys.
Thanks so much.
Awesome. Cheers, mate.
Thank you for watching Hummer TV with these two sexy folk, Kingswood.